Welcome back. Let's fly Kerbal Space Program Space Shuttle Development. We are plugging away at the rock. It's going to be an extremely cool aircraft. I'm very, very much looking forward to taking this one out for a spin, getting it working. I like what's happening with the wings. I like what's happening with the engines. It's our first test runs. We're just running down the runway. It seems that these things, I believe, aren't these engines, they're more for power high altitude, right? Perfect choice and brute force is required. Slow RPM changes. Yeah, these don't. Yeah, these aren't showing up a whole lot of. Well, they've got more max power than these guys. No, we'll stick with what we got for the moment right now. Anyway. Okay, so the rock, we haven't really decided how much force we're going to get out of the main engine yet. That's coming later. At the moment, the next thing that I want to do is we're going to make a really fancy looking kind of tail structure for this bird. And we'll start off with the first one vertical and kind of lining up with that engine right there. And you have to hold the right click. And now let's make that a little bit taller, give it a significant rake backwards. Yeah, very much like that. Too much rake backwards, you may say? No such thing. I don't like how they're kind of sticking outside. Can I attach these inside? Here's a thought. I could attach it to this surface right here. Turn the mirroring back on. Yeah, surface attached, mirroring back on. Put it right there. Angle it upwards like this, just real close to that top edge. Angle it like one click that direction. Two clicks, maybe. Yeah, about like that. Hold down right click so it doesn't match itself to the size. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, that looks like that'll work a lot better. We don't have this ugly edge extending up outside the top edge of the wing. Good. How big do we want the root to be? Yeah, okay, so we'll start off with a significant rake backwards like that. This piece isn't going to curve in anymore. This is the piece that we want to connect our rudders to. So I want this to come back far enough that whenever we come around the top, that any cargo coming out of the cargo bay will not be so much in danger of colliding with the tail. And also, the farther back we go, the more pitch authority we can get out of the elevator that are going to stick in this thing. Okay, now this piece, we want to angle it over a little bit. I keep on changing my mind a lot of these. And now we've come far enough backwards that you see that anything that comes straight up out of that out of the cargo bay won't hit the tail. More pieces. Let's go with these guys. Except, you know what, I need to rake this piece even more. Yeah, that looks better. Keep on thinking about this stock control surface part. Could I get away with putting that in the middle? I think maybe I could, instead of using these two separate pieces. Okay, I think maybe we've got something working now. Oh, that works. blending this all in like that. Yeah, I think I like it. That's going to be my rudder. Rudders. Plural. Okay, now we work on the rest of it. So at this point, it doesn't really need to taper a whole lot. So we need to start thinking about how am I going to make this horizontal, you know? Now we'll take this, and now we'll go for the horizontal piece. Yeah, like that. Good. See what we have, the 2 meter control surfaces, right? Yeah. There we go, I like that. And now I'm going to alter the way this fits in order to make it work. Here's what I need to do. We're going to take these pieces and we're going to like do the right click deal. So they're not actually going to respond to changes in those. Hang on, let's shrink the tip down. Good, like that. Okay, so I can alter the tip size of this one. Move it back like this. Oh yeah, that looks pretty sweet. Oh, nope. So difficult. Keep on clicking the wrong one. Be really careful what your mouse runs over. Okay, am I done fiddling around with this part? Is it gonna work? I think it's gonna work. We got a rudder, we have two rudders, we have an elevator, we have two ailerons. Granted, the elevator is kind of small-ish. We're probably gonna make these be elevons. I like it. Let's save it. Let's do a whole bunch of struts. Let's cross brace this whole mess up here. Say we'll attach a piece from there to the leading edge of this one. Yeah, that's nice and strong. Okay, save it. Let's do this whole FAR sweep in the control surfaces and whatnot. Sweep angle of attack. See if what this tells us anything interesting. Ooh, look at these crazy lines. Looks like we don't stall until we get up here, way up here to like 45 degrees. Which, that's nice. 45 degree angle of attack. Let's sweep Mach. How much does my thing weigh? 70 tons? Alright. That's acceptable. Okay, so 4 meter control surface. I said I want these to be elevons, so we'll have pitch and roll. 46 degrees seems like a lot. We'll run with it. I bet you the first time we fly it, we'll come back in. It'll give us some different numbers. Standard control surfaces. These are exclusively for yaw. 42 degrees. Again, that seems really large. And these guys are going to be exclusively for pitch. Again, with this 46 degrees, that's a lot. Update. Good. Okay. Now, let's see. This has been buggy. I don't really trust it. Oh, well, except now that it's centered. I mean, that's pretty much where I figured it would be. Yeah, our center of mass is very close to the center of the cargo bay. And our center lift is right back here, a little ways behind it, exactly where I would want it to be. Ooh, it's looking kind of pretty. Save it. Let's launch it. Go for our first flight, huh? Okay, there's the rock. Let's hide that. Go to precision control. Again, I'm doing, I discovered that the earlier space shuttle, that small one that was based on the real one, that was unpilotable except with a joystick. But this one, going back, we're using the keyboard again still because I want this to be shareable. I want other people who may not own joysticks, I want them to be able to use it. Okay, precision control is on. Let's trim back some, not a whole lot, but some elevator trim. Good. Tell you what, and let's go ahead and leave the OMS, let the OMS give us kind of a boost to get running. ...70-ton aircraft. It might take a little bit to get moving, especially as these things start off with... They take a while to spool up, you see. You can hear the engine pitch increasing. Oh, I forgot, did I do that? EAS, there we go. Change that to EAS, thank you. Side a little bit. I get lots of airspeed. Okay, we're over 100. Pitch back some. Oh, that nose wheel elevates nice and easily. Let's hold this angle attack for a bit. And pitch back a little bit more, and she flies off the runway so nicely. Retract that landing gear. Okay, let's kill the OMS. Let's run on just the jets now. You see it's decelerating some. I really want those jets to be strong enough to run this, you know. How much juice they push? 117. Electric charge. I haven't put any additional batteries in this thing. Okay, well that works. Let's do a nice gentle sweeping turn here. I think it's kind of underpowered. We may have to look at some stronger jet engines. But so far, the airplane is not exhibiting any bad habits, you know? So far. Yeah, all the control surfaces are working the way they're supposed to. Yeah, let's see. Thrust, 119.4, eh? If we try and pull back a little bit harder. Yeah, okay, minor stalling detected. Nose down a little bit. Yeah, we're definitely feeling kind of underpowered with these jet engines. I'd be happier if we had some more thrust out of those things. So I have to figure out a way to do that. I mean, our engine cluster is already looking kind of clustered. This airplane looks pretty cool, doesn't she? I think it's cool looking. These things are all working correctly, right? Yep. Nominal. And plenty of intake air. It's a large airplane. It's heavy and underpowered. It's kind of sluggish in these turns. The nose isn't wanting to wander to the left or to the right. We don't have any kind of, say, Dutch roll problems, so I'd say that my tail design is working correctly, which makes me happy. Okay, so when I do a rapid roll, yeah, the nose is off to one side a bit, but it comes back on its own even without touching the yaw controls. It fairly rapidly corrects itself. That's good. Another way it may Maybe I can put like a third engine mounted up on top of that. Think that would work? Or maybe pull these off and look for some stronger things. Maybe I change my mind about the sabers or something, huh? Okay. Let's consider a landing. Let's pitch back some more. Trim backwards. Trim nose up, I meant to say. I've been doing running for hours tonight. Granted, really designed this thing almost all in one night. My voice is starting to go away. Okay, lots and lots of pitch authority as we drop in airspeed. She still has fairly nice manners. Throttle back some more. Yeah, even down at 100 meters per second, equivalent airspeed still nice and controllable with the keyboard. Oh, kind of a rough landing. Kill that. Hit the brakes. Wish I had an arrestor chute, but for some reason the arrestor chutes we've had in the past, they don't work once you touch down. Stop. Okay. Well, that was... Yeah, that worked out just fine. Here, set the parking brake. Shut down the engines. Aerodynamically, I am very happy with what I saw so far. So at low air speeds, the design of the airframe, nicely controllable, has just the right amounts of lift. At the pitch and everything, that is balanced out just right. We didn't get to really try and see what happens at higher air speeds, because this is the problem that I'm seeing. Our engines are underpowered. Our jet engines are underpowered for a vehicle this massive. So that's something else we need to take a look at. Okay, yeah, engines have a problem, but the actual design of the vehicle itself, I am very happy with this. Let's open up the cargo bays just to look at it and see how nifty it is. And it's got a huge cargo bay. Huge! Yeah. Okay, I'd say that was several hours well spent putting this thing together. I am satisfied. I think it's actually the largest cargo bay that of any shuttle that I have yet put together. I mean, I've made a couple using these what do they call them, the HL series cargo bay, but none quite that large. Tail design is somewhat influenced by a Cessna Citation 10. I mean, for having the way it sweeps backward and it gets longer there. I'm personally not aware of any real life aircraft to have the bridges over like that. I mean, I'm sure they have some out there. But I just thought it was a tail design that would work, you know? Okay, yeah. We'll call it a day. We'll go back. We'll do some more thinking on giving it some better jet engines later. Although they are, I don't know. Yeah, they're just barely sufficient for what it needs right now. Okay, I'll stop recording. I will speak to everybody later. Bye.